So if you got this booklet, make sure you read the last page. It's a fold-out. It has something to say. Annette, thank you for your courage. It takes my breath away to listen to you. It leaves me speechless. It really does. The thing is, this is not an attack on doctors. It's not. In 1975, doctors were protesting, saying, pass this law, pass this law. And Jerry Brown said to Tom Girardi, who's in the room, he said, Tom, you know, they're protesting. I'm going to sign this. It's bullshit. It's unconstitutional. The Supreme Court won't uphold it. That was 2 years before I was born. 2 years before I was born. I served in the armed forces as a medic. And in 1998 is when I first handled my first medical malpractice case as a law student. I learned about this cap. I said, wow, this is insane. This has gone on for 23 years. It hasn't changed. It hasn't changed. But the doctors who were protesting, they were fed lies and propaganda from the insurance industry, who told them, listen, this is going to reduce your rates. It was a lie. It was a lie. And doctors need to, I want you to hear me. This isn't an attack on you. Stand with us. It's the right thing. And if we believe in civil rights, if we believe in our civil justice system, this is horrible, horrible. And it's not that the cap should be increased. No, that didn't work. It's got to go. It's got to go. And if we stand together with truth and honesty and an open heart, the thing is about this 2020 election, people's eyes are open. People's eyes are open like they've never been open before. We can make a change in 2020 if we stand together and stand strong. I have a little video I want you to see. Thank you.
Mia was 8 weeks old when her heart stopped beating because of medical negligence. She will live with brain damage and cerebral palsy for the rest of her life. Because of a law passed in 1975, negligence victims in California like Mia have been capped at $250,000 as the maximum compensation they can receive for lifelong, non-economic damages, such as loss of enjoyment of life, pain, suffering, emotional distress, and disfigurement. Wrongful death damages caused by medical negligence, loss of love, companionship, and the relationship of a loved one are also capped at $250,000. For 43 years, every attempt to change this cap has been defeated by the insurance companies who make billions of dollars in profits by keeping the cap in place. Tania's parents insisted in their birthing plan that under no circumstances would forceps be used when delivering their baby. The delivery doctor used forceps anyway without permission and crushed baby Tania's head, causing her brain to bleed, sentencing her to a life of cerebral palsy and living in a body that will never work. Sophia was in life-threatening distress without oxygen while her mother was in labor. Because of medical negligence, she suffers from spastic quadriplegia and cerebral palsy and lives in a body that will never work. These are three of many thousands of examples of lives that have been irreparably damaged by medical negligence. Getting rid of the $250,000 cap will not increase the cost of health care or insurance. Those are insurance company lies. The truth is that getting rid of the cap will save taxpayer dollars, reduce health care costs by making the insurance companies or the medical institutions and groups bear the responsibility for the costs of compensating negligence victims. And importantly, getting rid of the cap will put an end to over 42 years of dishonesty and lying to California juries who are not told that their verdicts are reduced to $250,000. In California, since the cap was out in place, medical negligence has become the third leading cause of death. That's according to the American Medical Association studies and research. In 2020, voters, independents, Republicans, Democrats, libertarians, all voters who care about equality, being honest with juries, civil justice, and who believe that patient rights are more important than insurance company profits, voters will have the opportunity to get rid of the cap that insurance companies, their lobbyists, and bought and paid for politicians want to keep in place for another 42 years.
Well,